Good evening, guys. Alright, so tonight is continuing on with my 30 creatures in 30 days thing. Yesterday I did a chimera, which I had never actually done before, which it turned out quite well. And I've also done a hydra, which I am going to post. Oh, sorry. I had an image of that, of those two. Soon. But tonight I will be doing an ice fairy hunter. So originally I just thought of just a fairy. Now I wanted to make it a little bit more interesting than just a girl with wings and maybe some flowers or something like that. Because you got to give them a bit more story, I guess. Especially to any creature or character you have. You gotta have it look like the character's got something behind it. So I went through the idea of having an elemental fairy. So, varying fire, earth, water, ice, sort of thing. And then I was like, well, that's not exactly a story, that's just a type of fairy. I needed some sort of profession for a fairy that I wanted to make. So I had a little of a mind map thinking about. Maybe you could do an artist fairy where she's got paintbrush and she's got like one of those paint rags on her and she's covered in paint and stuff. She's got a pencil behind her ear and hair or something. But I was like, maybe not. And then I went through maybe like an ordinary village fairy or even a warrior, with armor and a sword. But I was like, nah, it's a little bit too complicated for a quick drawing. And then the last two I sat on is a hunter and a mage. So I've been playing a little bit of World of Warcraft lately. And so that's where these kind of came in. A mage would have a robe, a staff, maybe magic pulsing somewhere. But then I was like, I don't want it to be like an older fairy sort of per se, more or less just a young, that sort of feeling. So then I sat with Hunter and I was like, well, what can I do with a Hunter? In WoW, they've got like a little pet. So what I'm going to do is give her two little birds, like two little ice colored birds that can help her, find out things, hide, maybe do some things for her. And then Hunter would generally have a bow, quiver, that sort of thing. I had done a little sketch in my book, just an overall idea of what she would look like, and I gave her like a scarf and some goggles and a little shirt tucked into her pants and some big gloves and stuff. So I'm just gonna go off that drawing now. So for fairy, we'll go to blue. We'll stay with the icy sort of feel. Cause it's a human character, we would start off with a human body figure. So for her, I'm gonna do a side view, so she looks maybe she's shooting or having a lookout or something. So I do a circle for the top of the head. I'm just gonna zoom in for the moment, and then a little bit of a line for her chin. She's gonna have, a fairly small face and have her head skull kind of come up there like that. Just simple shapes for the moment. And then her neck would come down like this. Alright. Now, this is going to be interesting. I've got to work out how I can make her look a bit more dynamic. So, her chest would come out like that. So, like, it's the side view of the ribs. So, normally you'd draw the ribs, so you've got that, and you've kind of got like an upside down heart shape, really. That's a good way to show an upside down heart. So, it would just be half that. Because, she's on her side. Just for the moment. Now, her shoulder would probably be about here, so we'll just draw that in there for the moment. Just the shapes. And then, so her spine would come down. Now, if she's aiming or looking over something, one of her legs will probably be up, like elevated, perhaps, like on a rock or a stool or something like that. So we'll come in and I'll bring it up a little bit. So that's where her knee would go, and it'll kind of come down. And then just a little bit of a triangle just to simulate that's where her foot would be. So I feel like that's a little bit short. We'll try that. And then this part would be where our foot goes down. I like to draw the ground, so like, you know, you keep your feet reasonably level. So this foot would be a bit more further, which I'll fix that as we go along. And this one would be behind a bit. And because the ankle, she's got it up a little bit, it would kind of come in like this. But we'll just leave it like that for now. Rough shapes. Looking at that, I definitely think I need to make those legs longer. So what I'm going to do is come in and just pick up this like that. So it's not really, you know, doing too much of a change, just enough so that it lengthens those legs. And then her first arm would most likely come to her face. Because that's where her bow would be, which is generally when you're pulling back a bow, your hand would come up to your ear. So I'm going to draw that first, just so I can get that line. Alright, so it goes back, and like that. And this other arm would be pretty much straight out, because she's, you know, she's got a bow, she'd have a bow here. It wouldn't be a very large bow, I feel, like for an ice fairy. And then the string would, so that would be farther up her head like this. And like that, a little tight bend, a little bit of a bend in there like that. And then the string would come in, quite even, because it'd be generally in the middle. So if it's not in the middle, just kind of, you know, scribble it out, you know, shape it up for now. Even if we make the bow just a tad smaller and the hand up more. Okay, maybe not so. That's alright. So it's quite strung out, but we can fix that in a moment. So that's, I guess, our rough, really, really ultra rough lines. And then we'll just lower the opacity on that and grab in a new layer. Grab a darker color. And come in and start filling in some of those lines. So this head will come in and have a chest. And would come down. And then the same with her back will come in her shoulders. And then her butt. Now, I'm going to have this leg over here in front. Just so it looks a bit nicer. Because I guess if you have that back leg and it's not as, you know, it just looks a bit funny if that leg were to be in front, I guess. Alright, and then we'll go like this. Keep some nice curves. And into the foot. Like this. We won't worry about too much detail because I'm going to put big boots on her, like big snow boots sort of thing. Because she's a snow fairy, you know, and she lands on snow. She doesn't want to, like, I mean, she'll be light enough not to sink, but it'll be like, you know, keep warm and all that sort of thing. Alright, and now I've got this one. So coming out of the same shape in there, and then out like this. Now I'm going to have to make that a bit longer, because if her foot's going like this, maybe she's doing a sneaky. And pretend her big toe's kind of like there, and it kind of goes up like this. Alright, now this arm looks like it needs to come out longer in general, so we'll move the circle to about here, not too much longer, because then it would come out and like this. Not quite like that. Let's just fix this up a little bit in here. Now that's definitely not looking. And then because it's going to be a fist, we're just going to do a bit of a square at the moment. Then I'm also gonna make this arm a bit longer as well. Although if that arm was straight, yeah, that would work. Alright, so we'll come in, add those arm bits all the way to the part on her face. Now you notice I like to move the screen around a lot. It just helps because, you know, you can't draw certain lines with certain sides. So if you're left-handed, some round bits would be easier if you're, you know, a different hand, like the shapes and the smoothness of them. So swapping around really helps. Now, just a shape for the moment, because, I mean, one of her fingers will probably be a bit like this, holding it in, because it'll be like an arrow. Now that I look at that, that means, because the arrow will most likely be straight across, because that's where she would be aiming, her hand is going to have to come up. Because, you know, maybe she's looking, but most times it would be resting. Because that would also have a finger, and the arrow. Fix that up in there. Doesn't have to be precise for the moment. I might even just chop that a little, just a tad. Back to shorter. There we go. Because the arrow would sit across the finger, you know, she'd be holding the bow. Her fist would be a bit more bigger than that, but, you know, she'd be holding the bow. Just do this like that. And then, yeah, so the arrow pieces would be in her fingers, so like the feathers or the whatever part of that. And then the arrow itself will come in and be sitting on a finger. Just, it's an aiming method, you know. Down your arm. Like that. Alrighty. Now I'm gonna come in and do that head, just the shape still. Maybe a nose. Just like that. And then that string would come in. Still quite a little bit off. That means the top of the bow needs to come more. But that's all right. That'll be okay as is. We can always fix it in a moment. So then we take that back layer, hide that. Lower this one. I'm going to shrink it down just in case I've kind of shortened things just because I'm going off the page a bit. Now. So I'm going to straighten this whole bow out. Just a little bit. So it's going to come up. Straight like this, and then I can go like this. So it's looking a little bit more even in where that string comes down. Much nicer. Alright, now with that, I'm going to start drawing in some of the details. So I'm going to start with her gloves first. So with bows, and especially because she's a snow fairy, she's gonna have some pretty decent gloves on, you know, to protect her from the cold and from the bow string itself. Just adding in Just some remnants of fingers for the moment. Actually, she should have two out because that's generally how you sleep. Because she'd hold the bow string like that. That would work for me. Alright. And then the elbow, we're gonna cut it out a little bit like this. It's looking a little bit odd. That's alright, cause I can always fix that. This one, because it's on the inside, I'm gonna bring it like this. And then her fist would be wrapped around it with one finger. Oops, draw an extra finger. Because then her thumb would come in a little bit like that. I mean, more often than not, we can have even have a second finger. You just gotta remember. Just like that. Hi! Hi, Bebe. Thank you. Oh, you do? That's really cool. What sorts of fantasy creatures? Oh, dragons and chimera? That's cool. The badass stuff. Yeah, no, that's pretty cool. That's cool. Do you do like, with the chimera, you can do different kinds of chimeras. What kind of chimeras do you do? Do you do like the normal goat and lion or with the snake tail, or do you like do like, you know, the cats mixed ones? Griffins, yeah. I think my griffin day is coming up as well because I'm also doing griffins and hippogriffs later on because I'm going through 30 different creatures. So we'll be doing a griffin on Friday. So this Friday night, I'll be doing a griffin if you want to come check it out and have a watch. You're also welcome. There's a link. If it's come up on the live stream, I'm not sure if it does or doesn't. To a Discord channel, you're welcome to come join and put up your own drawings in there if you like, and maybe I'll show them out later on. Ah, the dragon wings, yeah. Very majestic. A Wendigo? What? Aren't Wendigos like flesh-eating creatures? I mean, I got that from Supernatural, so. I'm not too sure of that creature. No, I don't. Yeah, I thought so. My terrible housemates being noisy. Shoo. Have you ever tried to draw a Wendigo? Like, I mean, the supernatural Wendigos I know are really like pull and stuff. Yeah. You have? Cool. Well, if you want, you can join that Discord. My computer's having a bit of an issue, so I won't be able to see it till later. But I can have a look if you come join. So I'm just doing a scarf. It's gonna look a little bit funny. I'm gonna work out where these wings are gonna come in. Hey, don't say that. Like, it's always about the practice. Like, you know, if you think you're not good, then you'll never get better, you know? You've got to believe in yourself. Fantasy expert, that's cool. Well, if I ever don't know something about a creature and you're around, I'll have to come ask. I mean, yeah, if you even if you don't want to chuck your drawings in, if you come join the channel, we can. Mermaids are not good. Well, tomorrow I'm doing a mermaid. Why, how come they're not too good? I mean, you could make a mermaid out of anything. Like, you could have, like, I've seen lionfish mermaids, I've seen. Oh, there's so many. Like, any kind of fish you could turn into a mermaid, really. And it's the same with dragons, you know. Yeah, true. Their actual lore is pretty bad. I guess that's the beauty, like a harpy. No, it's a siren. The sirens are just as bad too. I mean, harpies are pretty bad as well. Gotta work out what kind of hair. I feel like I want to try and get some spiky. Tengu? What's Tengu? Kind of sounds like a dance, but I'm assuming it's a creature. But don't mermaids technically do the same thing? Like, I mean, there's stories of mermaids that do that, like, I know Once Upon a Time, the TV show, there's the mermaids that the father wants them to use their voices to a Japanese creature. Ah. Oh, I think I've seen. Is it like a bird? A tengu is a bird warrior sort of thing? Yeah, I actually learned that from a game called Flight Rising. It's a if it's pretty good. If you haven't, okay, yeah, so there must be other species. Flight Rising has it's a dragon game where they've got creatures like the Tengu as familiars, and it's pretty cool. If you haven't checked it out or don't know what it is, you should check it out. It's pretty cool. I might bring that scarf down, actually. organ. I'm not sure. Multiple things. Is that like, what's come up as two different things, and I looked that in. Is Medusa or a bull? Like a Medusa thing or a bull? Gee, when I thought I knew a lot of fantasy creatures, I really don't know many at all. Think that arm is. Medusa, yeah. Yeah. If you like books and Greek mythology are good series. I used to read. I actually only found one book. I haven't actually looked for any more, but it's called Corygon. Corydon. And it's pretty cool. I haven't read it in a while, but Medusa and all that's definitely they're in it, and that's pretty cool. Humanoid snake race. Isn't that also Naga? The Naga are a human snake race. Oh, they're mostly snake, but like they're part human as well. I mean, that's another World of Warcraft reference there. Okay. Ah, okay. Yep. All mythology is great. I reckon if I had more time, I'd definitely research it more. Yeah. To be honest, I don't even know what that means, Stiffy. Oh, sci-fi. Is that what you mean? Sci-fi is like spacey sort of things, isn't it? Like space and aliens and spaceships and all that sort of thing. I don't mind either. Yeah. I don't mind either. I guess I prefer fantasy because, you know, the dragons and the cool creatures and all that sort of thing. But like spaceships and all stuff is pretty cool. I admire it because there's no way I could draw something like that. No. Not Final Fantasy. Final Fantasy's more fantasy because of the funny creatures, and they've got dragons and serpents and all that sort of thing. But yeah, Star Wars is definitely one. I like Star Trek and like definitely and Doctor Who and all that. Doctor Who's pretty good though. I don't mind that one. I really like that one actually. It's one I watch quite often. Waiting for the next Doctor to come out, to be honest. You watch Doctor Who at all? Or Torchwood or any of those sorts of things? Scooby-Doo. Yeah, Scooby-Doo. I haven't seen that in so long. I think the last time I watched Scooby-Doo was probably 2 years ago on ABC, which is an Australian TV show. I think it was ABC 3 or something. Or it might have been Toaster TV. I don't know, there's a whole bunch of little things that Australia does now. Yeah, Scooby-Doo's great. Actually, I heard lately, there's an episode of TV show called Supernatural, right? And they've actually done an episode where they're supernatural characters. This is like a real life sort of TV show, like so real people, actors and everything. They got turned into Scooby-Doo characters and they're like, oops. They're in the Scooby-Doo world. I'm not sure which episode or season it is, but it's like one of the newest ones. That like seems pretty cool. Yeah, I think it was relatively new, so it might be a while until it comes out. But I'm sure you'll get to see it one day. I'll see it eventually. One day I'll watch Supernatural again too. It's been a while. Alright, so I think that's all right. Wrestling? What do you mean? I'm not actually sure what that is. You mean is like wrestling another word for that? Is that what you mean? Wrestling, okay, yeah. Well, I don't really watch it, but I guess the moves and stuff are cool. I'm more of an animation, kiddie, love story sort of, fantasy, mostly animation style sort of things. And magic and all that. I tend to avoid like real life, like human things most of the time. Batman? Yeah, that's. Batman's cool. The different kinds of Batman is like the real life one, which my sister is obsessed with. Gaslight. I don't think I know that one, Gotham by Gaslight. I've only seen the TV shows that go live on it kind of reminds me of a game. Well, the image does, anyways. Very bloody. Ah, okay. I think the bloodiest thing I've watched lately. What is. Oh, I watched Shadowhunters this morning. That was pretty bad. But. I wonder if. I used to be. I could do a little bit of animation. I've done. I did a little bit last year for uni. I did 2 years at an animation uni. And there's an art club, yeah, maybe. I'd have to get my rusty skills as an animator back up. I'll see if I can find the ones I've done. I'm just loading up my website while I continue to draw. My style has always been really cartoon, though. So some of the a normal art club, yeah, I'd be happy to do that. Here's a portfolio thing which I made for uni with some of my other stuff that isn't on my other websites. That's cool. I'm still learning anatomy, so that looks, it really looks backwards or something, but that's okay. An error. Alright, why are you saying error, you silly thing? I'll try to go in something. I'm not sure why it would do that. Try. Nope, it's not working. Why aren't we working? That's really odd. Alright, well, I can grab the URLs then from some of the videos then. Alright, so if it works, there's this one, which is one of the ones I'm most proud of. I did the eagle. Like the big bird, and I drew some of the background houses. This is an old one. Never mind. Did it work? Yeah, if you wanted to collab, what sort of thing would you be interested, like, I mean, obviously fantasy of some sort. I also worked on a big project as well that I'm quite proud of. If I had to show one of my most favorite things I've worked on. We could do an animation one, but it would depend on the animation, 'cause I'm a little bit rusty, 'cause I haven't animated since like probably no December last year, or before that, because my friend did most of the animating. But I can do all the like a lot of the art and design, like in this one that I've linked you to. I did all the art. My friend did the animating, like the movement of the birds and stuff like that. But I created the characters and I drew it all out and I made the rigs for the animation and all that sort of thing for them to animate. It took like 13 weeks. Actually, it took like 26 weeks to do though. So it would really depend on the type of animation you're thinking about and also time, I guess, in real life, because I do a lot of things. Chibi? Maybe. Might work. But yeah, just, I guess as long as it's not like, you know, extremely detailed, like as detailed as this fairy I'm drawing. Silly kitties sound fun. Yeah, definitely. Maybe. Well, if you join yourself to the Discord if you haven't already, then we can. Yeah, but with music, if we do an animation, we either have to find something that's non-copyright or have someone else make the music because it's like really, you know, there's a lot of copyright in a lot of things. You have to be careful with a lot of stuff these days. And it's only getting worse, sadly. We could drive. I don't know about that. I have no experience and probably not enough time to do that myself. Yeah, of course. But yeah, because I also have a part-time job and all that sort of thing, and draw most night, all nights. So we'd have to really, you know, see what the scope of it all is. Well, I guess if we did, then you'd be in charge of that. yeah, that would be good. But yeah, so I guess we could talk more in detail and see about different sorts of things. Like more details, I guess, in like one of the PM later on. Oh yeah, definitely. That wouldn't be too bad. Yeah, definitely. But even simple designs, be careful with that because even simplistic sort of things can take a while to work on, you know, to make it look good. Yeah, definitely. Maybe. We'll see. I've only just started out, so I'm still also learning Discord in a way as well. And, you know, you can't exactly, you know, I only met you today online, you know. So, I guess maybe one day we'll see. I wouldn't mind that, but I guess one thing at a time, you know. We can't do, gosh, an animation and OC and make it story and all that sort of thing. Maybe. I've had different OCs before. I don't show them much because I want to go back and revamp them because I'm always practicing other creatures, but perhaps. Oops, that is not. Yeah. That sounds like a plan. One. Yeah, exactly, you know. And you know, we, you know, get to know each other and all that sort of thing before we do too much intense work as well. A furry, yeah? You might like my main OC who's somewhere in existence on my profiles. Her name's Raven. She's like a cat dragon thingy-majiggy. She's got an anthro body, and then she's got big cat ears and dragon tail. She used to have a cat tail, but she has a dragon tail, and she has dragon wings. She's pretty cool. I think that's the only like character I had that classes as a. Yeah? Oh, wish I could get Discord working and I could get you to put it there, but for some reason it's just not loading for me. Sometimes my computer has these hiccups. On my computer apparently it doesn't exist, so I'll have to have a look when I reset my computer after the stream. If you do want to put it on the Discord, that is. You don't have to. Okay, no worries. Alright, well. Anyway, so we're up to the part of this fairy where I've done a bit more into the design. So, more into the line art sort of section. And I've added spiky hair, some goggles so like when she's flying through snowstorms it can protect her eyes, and then a scarf that she can use for warmth as well as pull it up on her face if she needs to. And then now I'm down on her belt, which is where her arrows and all that sweet stuff is. Now they're all piled in one side because if she's leaning, you know, they're not gonna be just, you know, standing up straight like this. They're gonna be stacked to the side where gravity sits. And these little bits here just hold the quiver on her hip. Back over here, just adding some belts to her legs. I guess it would be a dual thing where she could put things on the belts, you know, like bags or satchels and that sort of thing, or she could even use it for extra warmth, you know, to press the pants closer to her. But yeah, just so those gives it a bit more customization to her pants as well. You know, they're not just plain, empty pants. Adding a bit of a ridge in there so that it, you know, shows that there is an extra bit of material. Boot, making sure her pants are on the inside of her boot, which keeps all the cool, like the cold in her legs instead of, you know, like it tucks her pants in her shoes so she's warmer. Because she's a fairy, she wouldn't really have any like zippers or any of that sort of thing. So it'd be just ropes tying things in, like, you know, shoelaces sort of feel to it. Like that. Same with the other leg, a little knee in there. Kind of going a bit out, so it does look like there's more shape to that shoe, so like there's a big gap in there, so it'd be like, it'd be black, but you know, it would show that there's more there than it's skin tight to a leg. Come like that, and go down into the tippy toe. Add the sole of the shoe. Oops, kind of looks a bit wobbly. Like that. Now, generally there'd be a lot more fabric in here, but I'm not too sure how fabric goes at this stage. Lots of little wobbly bits. Just showing there would be creases in where that belt is, but that's alright. Don't need too much, you know. It's a little simple little fairy. Same with under her arm, you know, there'd be on her chest, there'd be quite a few little bumps and things. There we go, there's that. Now I'm gonna come in some colour. Just briefly. Now, because she's ice, I'm gonna start with her. Oh no, I gotta draw her other wing. So her other wing's gonna be behind that, so it's gonna be a lot lighter in the back anyway. So you're gonna be able to see it here, but you're not really gonna be able to see it like that. So you know, she has a pair of wings. Alright, now we can get rid of that one. And then add another layer under it. I'm going to start with an ice blue for her hair to start with. I'm going to try that. That's a bit too... That works for the moment. Alright. take that back down. And just color that in like that. You know. Pretty cool. Cool colors for a cool fairy. Although, I feel like I need to make it a bit more. That's better. Ice colored, like less green but more blue. There we go. Now I'm going to stick with the blues for the moment and go darker blue, but more gray for these goggle brace, like other goggle pieces. Even darker for the rims. And then almost black for those middle rims in there. Now, I feel like her glasses would be slightly tinted as well, because... Not that tinted. Because if she's... I'll add more colour, I think. Because when she's out in the snow, everything's going to be a lot brighter, you know, than your average flying around sort of feel. So, she'd need something that could block out. Alright. So... We're going to our average skin colour to start, but she'd be a little bit more paler than the average skin colour, just because, you know, she's an ice class. So that would be... I mean, at the same time, you could really also make her more tan, because the sun reflecting off the snow could possibly make her more tan. It's completely up to you when you're drawing your fairy. The only bit of skin that shows is her face and her ear. That's alright then. Now I'm going to grab that same blue and go down a bit and do these gloves a bit darker. She kind of looks like an acclimatist at the moment. It's kind of interesting. Like that. And then I'm going to fix this up in there. I get a darker blue. Dirt, more of a blue, I feel like. Could go. That's better. Might do the same with the actual arm. No, that's okay. We'll leave it as is. Alright. Lots of experimenting. Good. I still feel like that should be at least. That's better. Might make those stitches a bit lighter though in just a moment. Just sizing it up. Sizing those colours up. You know, always testing. Testing your colours. Now, I still feel like this could go lighter, more icicle, like it's ice burnt, kinda, you know. She's been out in the snow too long and her hair's kind of frozen like that, in a way. And her wings would be similar, there would be a blue. Oops, we've kind of... Oops. Alright, that's pretty good for base colour, although we might still bring that up like that. Yeah. Alright, so because we're in the blues, just for something a little bit different, I'm going to make her scarf on orange-yellow, just like complementary. See how that looks? That's a terrible orange. More yellow. needs to be more faded, like sun faded. That's a bit better. Maybe a little bit more. That'll do for the moment, I think. Alright, and then for those end pieces, I'm gonna go darker. I haven't really drawn proper lines, I'm just gonna scribble color them in. It also draws your eye back up to the top of her body, giving her a different colored scar. Although I still feel like I need to make that more yellow. I'll just leave it as is. I'm gonna do it more closer to that brown, maybe. That's better. A tad darker for that back one then. Yeah, that's much nicer. I feel like that would be a lot more suited. I'm going to do the same with that arrow. I'm going to give her arrow feathers a bit more of a brown. Like that. And it's a darker brown for the actual arrow itself, and silver for the arrow head. It's a stone or even silver itself. Now back down to a belt. I might do that a brown as well. Like that. And then those feathers are this color. So just add that in there. Now I'll make that quiver just a blue again, easing back into that blue. Darker for this part. And then I might do a little bit of a fade. That's alright, like that. Oops. Just like that. There we go. Now I'm gonna make a more grayer blue for his pants. Her pants, or his pants, I'd feel like. Oops. Just like that. And darken this one because it's behind. And this blue can come over here, so it kind of looks like it's part of that quiver. The quiver doesn't really suit that color, so I'm gonna go gray instead. Just have to do this because sometimes Photoshop has a little bit of an iffy when it comes to coloring things. Just like that, see, because some reason it clicks and registers all the colors are the same thing and fills the whole thing in. Nap this brown again, cause nah, we'll talk. Bluey. Hi, welcome back. She's actually supposed to be fairy. She got her little wings here. But yeah, elves and fairies, same sorts of thing. But thank you. Yeah, she's supposed to be an ice elf. Oh, fairy. Ice fairy. Yeah. I think my Discord's having issues, though. If I couldn't open it for some reason. So, I might just have to link it when the stream ends if it doesn't open, because my computer's old and it's not working properly. So if you wait around for when I finish, I can chuck a new link in the description, because for some reason it didn't load up. Usually it opens and loads when I open it up, but for some reason it didn't work this time around. So if you're willing to wait till I've finished, I mean, I'm almost finished, like probably another 15 minutes max, if that's all right. Hoping with this new job I can afford a new setup, because this computer can get pretty ridiculous sometimes. It like just it fully glitches out and it's not fair. Like sometimes it takes two or three startups for just Photoshop to work properly. You can. I have to write that down. I'm still learning Discord again, so would I just search you somewhere? Okay, yep, alright. And then I can give you the link to the actual chat. Yeah, that's pretty fair. So yeah, send your name when you're ready. Alright, I'm gonna do a light shade, I think, just to make it interesting. Oops. Alright. It's just all lowercase like that. Once I'm finished doing this light shade and everything, I'll reset my computer and I'll add you in. Yep. I've written it in my book over here. So you can delete it if you need to. Yeah, I used to write. I haven't for a while because I kept getting all my stuff messed up. Like, I have this one big story I want to do one day with my OCs, Raven and Teaser and Mastercase. Pretty much all my OCs are linked in a story, but I keep building it because the more I meet new people, the more people I add to it. So I kept adding things before I finished it, and it kind of broke the story. So, I guess eventually I'll go back and I'll fix that up. It's more. It would definitely be good help. It's also finding a reason, like not a reason, a main story behind it. Like, I wanted to do with something to do with how humanity sucks. Well, not sucks, but like, you know, the world is terrible and how people abuse people and the unique people. If there was ever such thing as mythical creatures, they probably would be in cages because they're special and unique and that sort of thing. And the feel was meant to be like that, you know. There was a bad guy that wanted powers because he didn't have them, so he captured as many as he could. And was like doing experiments on all of them and all that sort of thing. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Like, even if someone grew a tail, they would literally be abused because of how special they are. And I hate that, like, you know. And like all the homeless people these days, they're all like, you know, spending money on fixing stupid things. Yeah. Exactly, like, you know, you'd be some sort of like preservist, but at the same time, being a preservist nervous might you know, hinder the creature in a way because, you know, you have all those wildlife places that reckon they're doing the world good by putting the endangered creatures in cages. Some of them are, but like some of them just have the creatures because they can, and it's horrible. Yeah, true. There's lots of things humans don't need, and it's just, you know, they could stop spending money on those sorts of things and actually look after the world. Yeah, of course, there's a lot of things that are useful that, you know, you don't need. But the way the world works is if it gives to the rich, then that's what people care about these days. It's kind of sad. But yeah, that's the kind of the feel of the story I wanted, you know, something to do with a bunch of characters that were against the whole, the way the world works, and they were like, yeah, true human. Would guess it would depend on the type of human. Like, if the human was, you know, a nice, you know, that sort of thing, that would be fine. I mean, I wouldn't want to watch it either way, but you know. Yeah, true. Like, you know, some of the crankiest, some of the people that get really aggressive and stuff, it just had a bad life. And if they're willing to change, if people were nice to them, then that's fine. But if they're not, then that's their own fault. I hate the people that, you know, yeah, they've been mistreated, but they're like, the world at their feet because, you know, they've been mistreated. Yeah. Thank you. I try to be as nice as I can. You know. There's no point in being rude. Yeah, that's fair. But yeah, there's no point in being rude, even to the people that are being rude to you, because you don't know what's around, you know. Even on bad days, you've got to think positives. Yeah. And that's how this society works. Like, you know, most people at schools, the young kids get bullied because of people like that, you know. Like, I'm better than you, so. Yeah. But yeah, that's what I'd want to write a story about. But it's just, you know, bringing the good characters and trying not to get overwhelmed with things I like. So, like, another big problem was I like dragons, so I had to put dragons in there. I liked, you know, bows and arrows and flying, so I had to put that in there. I've got to try and, you know, make a story that makes sense. Not just put things in there because I like them. Yeah, true. I mean, did they ever bully you ever again? I mean, I'm not, I don't like violence at all, but like, if they don't bully you ever again, then if it's that bad. Like, you know, people don't deserve to be bullied, and the people that are doing the bullying should, like, seriously. Yeah, exactly, you know, they don't do it again. You've just got to be careful because you don't want to get go to jail and stuff like that for doing something because, you know, they're hurting you. When school finishes, it's over. You don't deal with them ever again. That's my big, that was my thoughts in school, you know. I mean, I wasn't bullied as much as most, but it was more like, I'll be out of here soon, you know. I'll be doing my own thing. Like, you know, all my teachers, I was pretty bad at school. Oh yeah. Probably try not to swear on YouTube because YouTube can be a bit finicky with swear words. You know, I don't want to be banned or blocked. Just started. If you know what I mean. Like, I don't mind if you swear in Discord and stuff, but like in on live YouTube, try and mind your language a bit, you know. I swear quite a lot, actually. Like, I mean, not often. Like, I guess I do if I'm extremely frustrated or something like happens, but I try not to swear because I try and keep like a positive mindset, you know. Everything seems to happen for its own particular reason. Like, you know, I think the worst swear word I will use is probably the F word, to be honest. Like, I'm not that much of a swearer. I'm pretty peaceful of a person. Yeah, it does. My housemates, especially the gamers, swear quite a lot. But I guess it is only a bunch of words, and it depends on the tone and the place and the way you use it. Like, you know, if you go and, you know, you're saying, oh, I'm having a effing great time, you know, that's great. But, like, if you know, you're you're calling someone a really bad name just because you lost in a game. That's pretty bad. Yeah, I use that one too. That one's probably the most used swear word. Wow. That's odd. I've had people like message me. I mean, I'm pretty sure they're all bots, but like do silly stuff like that. It's like, really? I really don't have time for this, please. A lot of the time, if people approach you and say stuff like that, they're most likely bots. Can be quite annoying. Like, it's like, I don't want anything to do with that, you know, please go away, sort of feeling. Like, there are people that are into that sort of thing, but I'm just like, no, thank you. Like, you know, I don't mind reading stuff that's, like that, in a way, not really that often, but you know, when people say that sort of stuff, it's like, please no, this is the internet, nobody wants to see that. There's people that do want to see that, but you know, I'd rather not. I don't know. I guess it's just the human race, you know? They're like, it's just how people are. And I can never understand why. It's also like, you know, democracy and all that stuff. You know, if you're not wearing the best fashion, that too, yeah. Like, you know, it doesn't matter what people think of themselves. I mean, when it starts breaching the law, it's a little bit overboard, but like, you know, in personal stuff, like, you know, if you want to be called something, then so be it. Wow. That's really unfair to your friend. I have so many friends that, you know, are bi, lesbian. They get called different pronouns to their biological nature. See, I generally try to avoid that sort of thing. I'll just be like, you know, block them and ignore them, that sort of thing, because I avoid conflict as much as I physically can, you know. If I don't have to talk to the person, I don't want to, you know. But I'll generally not talk to someone if they're being rude. Oh, my best friend is gay, but, well, she calls herself gay. She's like complicated. She sometimes is goes by they pronouns, sometimes goes by he pronouns. But you know, she's still a human being. She's still my friend. I'm not gonna shit on her for what she wants to be, you know. And then I used to have a friend who was biologically female but went by male pronouns, you know. They do whatever they want. There's no need to fight about it. Like, you know. Oops. It's like the same as professions, you know. People shit on you until they know what you can do. So, like, I want to be a nurse. But, you know. What does that mean? Well, I mean, it's, I guess, as long as you're not trying to do, you know, certain things, like, that'd be kind of weird if you know, you actually physically tried to do stuff with the animals, but it's okay to be attracted to something. You know, you could be attracted to something and not, you know, sleep with them and that sort of thing, but you know. I'm not gonna dish you for it, you know, it's how you feel. It's like, I mean, I'm completely a straight female, you know, likes guys, but I'm not gonna call that normal. It's not normal. People are just, yeah, exactly. So it's fine, because an animal is a different thing, but you know, if you like an animal, that's fine. It's like furries. You know, people like furries, but it's not weird, so why would liking an animal without doing anything be weird, you know? It doesn't. Well, I guess it depends on what kind of chair it is now. It also depends on how the person acts about it, you know. If someone's gonna be like all weird about it, then it, of course it's gonna be weird, but if someone's gonna be like, yeah, no, that's fine, you know. Since it's whatever, I like this, you know. But if they go, oh, I really, really like this sort of thing, it's just creepy, you know. Yeah, cats are cool. There's a lot of furry cats on the internet. A wheelie chair. Well, wheelie chairs are fun. You spin around in them and that sort of thing. But, you know, I'm not gonna judge them for some what they like. You know, they like what they like. You know, if they're nice people, it doesn't matter. But if they did something like that in front of me, I would be very weirded out. Like, you know, I don't mind getting told things like that, but like once it's acted upon in my in the front of myself, that's just weird. Like, you know, you're not gonna sit there and make out with your boyfriend or girlfriend in front of someone. That's just over the top. Oh yeah, you still wouldn't judge them, but you'd sit there and be like, do you really have to do that right here, sort of thing. But yeah. Alright, I'm gonna give her a shadow. Yeah, it would have been. Definitely. Actually, I might. I mean, the only people I kind of semi-judge are the people that look really scary and act scary, you know, like people like drug addicts and like people who are drunk and that sort of thing. I mean, I don't judge them, but I get a bit scared of them, you know. You avoid them out of respect, like, you know, I'd really rather not be attacked by you right now, sort of thing. They're the only people I get a little bit iffy around. Just because, you know, I'd rather stay out of conflict and just live my life doing what I really feel like doing. My elf kind of looks like an army elf. But yeah, I guess there's my fit with your elf. I'm not, why am I saying elf? Yeah, the whole thing's kind of glitching out. That's all right. Little fairy. Oh yeah, that's fun. Like, you know, I know people who look scary and are nice, but like, if you don't know someone, or someone doesn't know some like that someone, and you walk past them on the street and they're, you know, smoking or acting like really creepy and stuff, you generally avoid them. Like, that's what I mean. Like, you wouldn't go up to them and be like, "Hi, my name's blah, be my friend." You know, you'd genuinely be terrified by that sort of thing. But yeah, if you're all chill, I think I'm gonna hop off and get you on Discord and probably go to bed because in Australia here it's 11:30 at night and I've had a pretty busy day doing a bunch of stuff. But because you like dragons, I'll show you something cool because you were on. If yeah, you've probably already seen the tooth, no, the spire drawing I've got on my other things. But I have been drawing this little guy. This is what I'm currently working on. This little toothless dude. yeah. Oh, right, really? British. Oh, nice. Britain. I'd be keen to go to like that area one day, but you know, with all the everything getting more inexpensive. Oh, you didn't see Spyro? No worries. I'll open it up here then for you. March. There we go. It took me a couple weeks to do it on and off. It was kind of like, you know, doing bits and pieces here and there and everywhere because the best thing to draw sometimes is to work on it slowly because when you come back and you look at it, then it looks cool. Like, you know, you see the different things that change. Well, the background is from the original games, but the actual dragon is kind of like the older version. I kind of mixed it up a bit, you know. I did the eggs from the egg, the gems, the dragon, and the like the crystal dragon and the background from the original games, but then Spyro himself and Sparks is from the later games, but not Skylanders. Yeah, the Skylander one's a little bit like I don't hate him. I hate what they did with him in the Netflix series. Like, if you ever get to see that, don't think of him as Spyro, is all I gotta say. The Skylander Spyro is like a jock. They've made him into a jock on Netflix. Like, you know, I'm better than everyone else because I'm Spyro sort of attitude, and it is terrible. But if you don't think of him as Spyro and you think of him just as another dragon in the Skylanders world, it's an alright TV series. Like, the Skylanders generally is pretty cool. Like, I like the creatures they make in them and the games themselves as a separate standing thing. Yeah. Yeah, jocks are horrible. I don't understand why they act like they do. But again, not judging, you know, they act how they do because that's how they act, but you know. Well, so is it okay by you if I head off and I can continue chatting with you on Discord once I get it set up and reset my computer? I'm also borrowing my housemate's gaming headset, so he's probably gonna want a game soon. This YouTube lag thing is terrible though. Like, it's like 2 seconds, but like 2 minutes behind what I'm actually saying, so it's hard to like. Okay, well, I'll, yeah, true, true, true. I'll, head off till. I'll be back tomorrow night to. What am I drawing tomorrow night? I've got it all, like, written. So, the evil mermaid. We're doing a mermaid tomorrow night. True, true. But yeah, well, I'll, log off. For the other guys watching, if you like what you see and you're interested in a drawing, then there's links below to all my other social media websites. And I'll be back on tomorrow at 10 p.m. to draw a mermaid. So yeah, come check it out. And if you're interested, I will reset the Discord link once I reset my computer because my laptop hates me, I swear. And I'll see you all later. Have a good night, day, wherever you are. And if you like drawing, keep it up. And yeah, thumbs up, thumbs down, and subscribe if you like. And thank you for Bear Bear. Thank you for your lovely conversation. It was really nice. It was really. I almost didn't stream tonight actually because I fell asleep. I was reading and I fell asleep and almost didn't stream. Oh no, GLaDOS. Well, I'll be back tomorrow at 10 p.m. to draw a mermaid. So if you want to come back, then it's also recorded. So this whole stream's recorded, and it'll be up on YouTube as well as all the other ones I do, if you're interested. But yeah, I'm gonna try and be on every night, weekdays on 10 p.m. Unless I get a bit too busy, then I might go 3 days a week. But that'll be the minimum I do. But yeah, I'll see you all later. And I'll reset the link in the Discord. Just give me probably about 10 minutes to reset my computer. And yeah, come join. See you later.